Hey everybody, it's the Boss Lady here, coming to you with Talk About It Tuesday. I'm actually pre-recording this, so this is actually Monday, but this will be posted live on Tuesday. Because something dropped into my spirit, and I was actually going to wait to do this video, but something dropped into my spirit, so I wanted to go ahead and get it out now. For all the mothers out there in YouTube land, I hope you all had a wonderful Mother's Day, regardless of what you did, regardless of what you received. I hope just seeing your babies, knowing they're healthy and breathing, that you just enjoyed your Mother's Day. Now, let me get into the reason why I'm doing this video now. I was watching a lot of people on social media, you know, throughout the weekend in reference to Mother's Day. You know, I even came across some person who posted something about, oh, you know, we need to shout out the single fathers because single fathers, you know, they're putting it down or they're holding it down too. So, you know, we need to wish them a happy Mother's Day as well. Then the controversy was, well, they get Father's Day, blah, blah, blah. No, everybody need to be telling them happy Mother's Day as well. Okay, so let Boss Lady, you know, chime in on this. First and foremost, when a child is conceived, a child has two parents, regardless if the parents are married, if the parents are just, you know, one night stand, whatever. You know, a child has two parents. They have a mother and they have a father, period. Now, if by chance the actual mother is not in that child's life and the child is only raised by the father, okay, but yet and still, when it comes to Mother's Day, it's about the mothers. It's about the one with the ovaries. I'm sorry. I'm gonna have to get blunt like that, you know. And it's for those who, regardless if you birthed that baby, if you gave that baby just love, unconditional love as their mother, that's what Mother's Day is about, that unconditional love. Now, if you are, you know, a male and testosterone and all that stuff, you got Father's Day. That's coming up in June. But May is about mothers, Mother's Day. I also ran across people, and I don't know, I think this was more more of a younger generation, but then again, I did speak to an elder, and I don't know, but the younger generation was complaining that, oh, they weren't getting breakfast in bed and, you know, I want homemade breakfast. I don't want to go out to eat type of stuff. And I don't know. I guess I'm looking at it from this perspective. Has he been making your breakfast? Okay, let's just be honest. If he hasn't been making your breakfast, don't expect it now. You know, if you're not with your baby daddy, why are you expecting him to wish you a happy Mother's Day? Granted, yes, you're raising his child, but come on now. It just drives me crazy. And you know, I come across a lot of men who always say, oh, we're in a woman's state. We're in a woman's state. It's all about the woman. Okay, well, if you would do what you're supposed to do from Jump Street, you wouldn't have to worry about it being a woman's state. I'm just saying. But you know, some of them, they're not handling their business. And well, when you don't handle your business, it don't matter if it's a woman's day, it don't matter if it's a man's day. I don't even get that anyway. If you're not doing what you are designed to do, which is support, care for your children, then don't sit and start complaining. You know, when someone's coming after you saying, hey, you know, responsibilities is this, you know what I'm saying? And excuse me, because I'm backing into my parking space. But anyway, you know, but there was just so many different young women yesterday on Mother's Day that was complaining because, oh, I didn't get nothing. I didn't get flowers. You know, they were sitting back and watching what other people were getting, and they complained about it. You know, he didn't get me no flowers, and, oh, my baby daddy didn't tell me happy Mother's Day. Let me tell you something. Let me be truthful. Let me be honest. Let me turn this car off. If my daughter's father never said a mumbling word, I would be okay. You know what I'm saying? Now, y'all know I have, you know, my husband, and I also have my daughter's father. My daughter's father, I don't think, has ever said happy Mother's Day. And with my husband, you know, when his mother was alive, he didn't actually honor Mother's Day either with me. And I thought that was very wrong and rude and whatever. But then we had a conversation. He said, well, you're not my mother. And at the time, I want to say we didn't have Miss Pina either. So he didn't understand the whole, you know, this is your wife and you still should, you know, honor your wife as well, you know, whatever. It wasn't until after we had Miss Pina that he was like, oh, you know. And then once his mother passed, you know, Mother's Day for him was really hard. So then I kind of felt like, well, dang, I shouldn't say anything because, you know, his mom is not no longer here. But he does make sure that Miss Pina, you know, she gets me a card and, you know, they give me little gifts and stuff. And, you know, I'm good with that. And my only thing is, you know, I'm not one of those women where, oh, he got to shower me with diamonds. I got to have Coach and Michael Kors and, you know, get me this and get me that. As long as you are respecting me, as long as you are loving me, as long as I can trust you, I'm good. You know what I'm saying? My only request on Mother's Day is that I don't cook. Because I'm like, that's the only day that I shouldn't have to cook anything. When I woke up on Mother's Day morning, you know, we woke up and I actually was up first. I actually left the house. You know, they were asleep. I gotta go. Okay, well, where are you going? I'll be back. You know what I'm saying? And I went and spent, you know, 15, 20 minutes with my own mother. When I came back, then they surprised me with my gifts, which I was appreciative to. You know, no, I didn't get breakfast in bed. No, I didn't, you know, get breakfast before church by his hand. You know, he was like, I got something to do. I said, okay, Miss Peanut, get dressed. We're about to go. We went out. We had breakfast. You know what I'm saying? I don't have a problem with that. I don't need a man per se to you know, validate me being a mother, because no, I just don't. You know, I had my beautiful child with me, and then later on in the morning I got to see my other child and my grandchild. You know, that's my legacy. You know, my husband is not my legacy. I mean, he's my best friend, but he's not my legacy. My lineage is my children. You know what I'm saying? So there were so many people that were complaining and so upset that, you know, well, he didn't do this and he didn't do that. Well, what did your children do? Did your children say, Mama, I love you? Did your children make you a card? Did they, you know, scribble something on some paper or whatever? Did they ball up a little wad of paper and put it on a stick and say, Mama, here's a rose for you? If your children did something for you, then that's what you should be appreciative to and happy about. Let me tell you what Miss Pina did that I was so shocked. Y'all know Miss Pina just got into a new school. She went for her shadow day. I did not know this. Now, mind you, I asked her a million and 12 questions what happened at school. But Miss Pina held something so dear. And I was just like, okay, I kind of got a little bit offended because I'm like, wait a minute, now you hold secrets? But, you know, she wanted to do something so special for me. They were making books at school, at the new school. Literally books, like they were bound and hardback cover, everything. And what she did was, one half of the book is all about Mommy. Then the other half of the book will be all about Daddy. And so what it is, it starts off, you know, up and down this way for me. But then if you flip it this way, then it'll say something about Daddy. And then she has all these pages where she can write about him, draw about him, whatever. And she's going to present that to him on Father's Day. And then we can keep the book, you know, for the rest of our lives, basically. So I told her when she's done with the Father's Day piece, I want her to put the date in there, put, you know, 2017, so that we can remember this year. You know, I thought that was so cool. And she wrote so many beautiful things about me, you know, that I was just like, wow, you know, I just started crying, let me tell you, you know. So, you know, so some people that might be like, oh, she just made you something. Those are the best gifts. Let me tell you, those are the best gifts. Just like when people are doing DIYs as opposed to going out shopping, I'm now starting to see those are the better decor items. You know, if you can DIY it yourself, y'all know I'm not DIYer to a certain extent. So, you know, yeah, I still shop for things. But if I had that gift, if I had that skill, like some of the people I see on YouTube, Lord have mercy. You know what I'm saying? So there's nothing wrong with a homemade or handmade gift, because that was the ultimate. You know, I got to spend service with my children. That was an ultimate gift for me, you know. Now, I will say, you know, Boss Man, he did honor what I asked. You know, I didn't have to cook. You know, he said, what do you want? I told him the restaurant. Boom, I got it. So, you know, but it wasn't just, so, oh, I got this, I got to have this, or, you know, you got to spend thousands of dollars. Number one, I'm not his mother. So he don't have to do that for me. Out of respect and out of honor, because I gave birth to his child, he does honor me, and I appreciate that. You know what I'm saying? You know, even in the midst of his pain, he honored me yesterday. And so I appreciate that, and I love him for that. But it's not something that is expected. And the reason why I say that is because I did speak to an elder. Now, mind you, like I said, I was, you know, talking with some young folks, and they was complaining. But then I spoke to an elder. This woman is in her 60s. Her child is grown. She's a grandmother. No problem. Well, she got up, and her husband didn't do anything for her. Didn't even acknowledge the day. And she said that hurt her feelings. Now, I feel if you've been married 40 plus years, you know, y'all empty nesters or whatever, there should be a little bit of acknowledgement there. I mean, even if it's just to say, you know, I may not make you breakfast, but, you know, we gonna pick up a little something, maybe have a little movie, you know, a little quality time, something like that. You know, it don't have to be, you know, super extravagant, but something to acknowledge the fact that, oh, you went through some pain to have my child. You know what I'm saying? So she was very offended. And at first, you know, my husband thought, oh, well, maybe, you know, maybe they just having a tit for tat. And I said, no, it goes deeper than that. And so when I explained to him what it was, then he was just like, oh. And then he said, now I get how you used to feel. Exactly. Because it's the acknowledgement that counts. You know, even if you don't have the money to, you know, buy something, you know, if you acknowledge me, if you give me that honor, respect, I appreciate that. You know, so I do understand those who didn't get any type of, you know, acknowledgement. But I mean, if you have friends or family who say, hey, happy Mother's Day, I know you done had a baby, blah, 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 take it and go with it, you know. But it's really not about the whole validation from a man. You know, if you have your child and your child is living and breathing, regardless if they, you know, are, you know, to some degree normal or not, whatever, you know, be happy, be thankful. You know, I hope every single mother enjoyed their day in whatever capacity. And I will tell you, this was the first year that we did more than enough, I guess you would say. Boss Man and I, we went out on a date Saturday, and I was looking forward to that date. If I didn't do anything else Sunday on Mother's Day, that date on Saturday was the ultimate for me. And it wasn't for acknowledging me as being a mother, but acknowledging me as a woman. Acknowledging me as his wife, acknowledging me as his confidant, his best friend, his all and then some. You know what I'm saying? That's what I was looking forward to. You know, my kids are going to honor me no matter what, you know, Lord willing. But, you know, I was looking forward to my date, and I had that. So when Sunday came, I was cool. When he had something to do and, you know, wasn't going to cook breakfast, I didn't have no bones about it. I was like, oh, okay, cool. You know, come on, Miss Peanut. We about to roll. You know what I'm saying? And we did. And it was fine. And we enjoyed ourselves. And everywhere we went, you know, somebody acknowledged me. Oh, happy Mother's Day. Thank you. Appreciate it. Love you. You know, whatever. You know, went to church, same thing. So I guess people got to get into a comfort zone. You know, they got to get out of this whole living up to these certain standards that are not even standards, you know. It's sad. It's really sad. You know, and I deal with a lot of, you know, different people in my everyday life, and I'm just like, wow. You know, I mean, I had people just, oh, well, I'm just gonna stay in the bed and whatever, and okay, if that's what floats your boat. You know, I kind of sent out a few pictures to a couple people, and people were telling me, oh, you're so relaxed looking, and you look so refreshed, and you da da da. Yeah, because you know what? At this point in my life and Boss Lady's life, guys, life is too short. And I'm going to live it to the fullest. I am going to make sure that I do what I want to do, that I'm not sitting here stressed out and worrying and whatever. I can't do it anymore. I cannot be stressed. So with that being said, guys, hope you had a great day. Hope you had an excellent Mother's Day. I hope you found something within this Talk About It Tuesday that you can take away from and apply it to your everyday life. You know, maybe share it with someone who didn't have a great Mother's Day. That might help them a little bit as well. But I gotta go, so I will see everybody in a new video. Bye-bye.